something that I'm just curious about. So obviously we had a lot of peaceful protests, really beautiful throughout West Hollywood, throughout the city of LA, and really like moving, you know, very, very touching and incredible. Recently, probably 2 weeks ago, I was on, I'm on a different site in Lincoln Heights, and I had to call the LAPD. And while we're just kind of hanging out talking, I just asked the officer, you know, what has this been like for you given the media? And he shared something with me that really blew me away. He's like, so it was a Monday, and he said, this morning we had our staff meeting, and it turns out there was an LAPD vehicle that there was a bomb under it. And so now we're being told that we have to search our cars every morning. And then he shared with me that he has a son, he's a parent, and he's walking on the street, and a four-year-old or a kid, he said, flicks him off. And then his mother says, don't even look at the police officer. Like, didn't say don't flick this adult off, this police officer, but said to not even look at them. And one of the concerns I obviously have is, like, I just feel like nobody's talking, and we're just moving into these completely scary situations. As you think about leadership during this time, obviously this is like an impossible challenge, right? Or so it feels like it. And I don't know if you have the right answer, but I just kind of wanted to get your thought process around this, because for me as an outsider, to some extent, right, I'm certainly not a politician, but just hearing these two anecdotal stories, I just thought this has got to be a tough time for leadership, for politicians to navigate.
Yeah, I mean, many problems would fall under this description, but this one in particular, you're not going to politician your way out of it. You have to be real. You have to be willing to have tough conversations. You have to be willing to create the safe space for people to be honest about what their experiences have been, and, you know, and also be prepared to dig in and do the work for the long haul. This isn't something that's going to change overnight or get better overnight. And, you know, I have a friend who's raising her with her husband, raising two kids in their home. And her son had said that he always thought that you were, when police showed up, you were supposed to run away. Like, he had the, you know, he's very young and had this impression, like, when police show up, you're supposed to run away. And she goes, huh, I have to do something about that. And she actually reached out to our local sheriff's station and had a conversation with the lieutenant there and said, you know, would you mind come, you know, my son's about to have his birthday. Would you mind coming and like meeting my son and, you know, having this conversation with him? And so they did, and they brought the police car and the flashing lights and all the things that the kids got excited. But, you know, putting a human face on something helps to address what you talked about, you know, create that very tense dynamic. And that tense dynamic also comes from human interactions in neighborhoods where that's not how people are experiencing law enforcement. And that isn't right. How law enforcement shows up in a community. And so we have to also be mindful that just because, you know, in a place like West Hollywood, that's relatively safe and has, you know, for the most part, a good working relationship with our sheriff's station, there are communities where that is not the case. And we have to be open to hearing that and willing to do better and work at it. And, you know, and also be willing to be as upset about, you know, when we're hearing, you know, incidents of police brutality as we are when we're hearing about property damage or, you know, things like that. We have to make sure that we're prioritizing people's lives first. That's why people say Black Lives Matter. We have to make sure that, you know, we're really thinking about those things and taking, being accountable and taking responsibility.
Hey, everyone. Thanks for checking out that clip. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button down below. And if you're interested in hearing the full episode, it's out right now on our YouTube channel. We've had a lot of great guests come on this show before, and we've got a lot of great guests coming up in the future. So hit subscribe so that you don't miss a single episode. And one final note, we're always looking for new ideas and new companies to feature on the show. So if you know of someone or know of a company, write us a comment down below letting us know who they are and what they do. We'd be happy to have them on the show. Till then, I'll just be here waiting for your comments. So, see you later.